busting out another build for your viewing pleasure or displeasure, however you're feeling today. AMT's 1966 Chevy Nova SS in 1/25th scale. It's a 2-in-1 build, stock or custom. Let's open the box, see all the parts that'll be inside when you get yours. I will link down in the description. This was sent by Round 2, so there'll be links down in the description, as always, where you can get your kit. Check out that chassis pan. As you can see, there's a lot of it done, but there will be a lot that needs to be glued on for detail and separate detail on this kit. Got that beautiful Nova body. I like that the trim is not molded in on the bottom of the doors, nor is it on the trunk. That means we're going to get to see some parts that are separate, which I'm looking forward to. This should be removed, by the way, and obviously those get removed, but this is not part of the car either. So you remove that. That's just so that it holds itself together when it's molding. We've got the interior. Very nice interior bucket there. Not even a bucket on this one. You still have room for your seats, or you can leave the seat deleted. Whatever you want to do on your interior there, you got lots of options. Separate parts rolling around inside the bag was one inner fender. The hood scoop, which is an option on this ride, of course. We got the top of the scoop, the bottom of the scoop. You'll have to cut a hole in the hood coming up here if you want to use that scoop. You don't have to, but it'll help to display it. We got our interior door panels. The Nova SS was a nice car, but it wasn't a luxury car, so the door panels aren't extremely fancied up. We've got our nice bench seat in the back, and our SS Sport bucket seats in the front, and our seat backs right there, all on one tree with our radiator and surround. On this one, we've got our full factory exhaust. We've got our suspension parts, sway bars, links, kingpins, all on one tree there, nice white plastic. On this tree here, we've got our firewall, radiator support. We've got numerous small underhood details like master cylinder, strut mounts. We've got our other inner fender there. We've got the nice dashboard. We've got the hood. If you flip it over, you can see the cutout for that hood scoop. Hood hinges, if you like that whole look. It's got two engines in this kit, as you'll see. This one can be displayed on a separate engine stand. That's all included, as if he's working on something. I love that idea. We've got our regular V8 that'll be in the car, heads, shocks, optional headers, differential, springs, drive shaft are all separate on this one. We've got our wheel backs. We've got the rest of our engine parts with stock manifolds as well. Carburation, so you have a lot of options to build this one up and detail it as either a stock or custom ride. Go to the other side of the desk, we've got our steering wheel. Clear glass parts, windshield, side windows if you want to do them, otherwise you can cut them. Just have the rear windows up, whatever, however you want to display yours is up to you, and the headlights are on there, of course. We've got one metal axle. We've got two other chrome trees besides the steering wheel. Check out that trim. We've got the rear body trim over the trunk. We've got the rear bumper. We've got the headlight surrounds, grille and bumper as one unit that we'll be putting our clear headlights in. We have our hood trim, interior console, optional wind valve covers. I love saying it wrong because people get so upset in the comments. Dual intake there, high rise, velocity stack options. Look at those beautiful wheel options molded open. You can see my chubby little hand right through them. On this tree here, we have our stock wheel option, stock air cleaner, valve covers, mirror, all your stock options. Mine, the back of the box only shows four tires, doesn't have a whole stack there. Usually it does if there's more, but mine has eight tires in it, all the same. White wall, bias ply tread, black wall on the other sides, hollow tires, so they'll go on easy. I don't know if they all have eight. Mine did, so maybe I'm just a lucky little boy today. And we got the new decal sheet. Check it out. Black stripes, white stripes as option. Hood and trunk trim right there. We've got our emblems and our call-outs, the stuff that's hard to paint on a car. We've got car silhouettes, numerous license plates, and some custom flame jobs and AMT logos. So that is a nice assortment in this 2-to-1. I'm going to get to building my version and I'll be right back. This kit, not being as old as some of the other reissues we see from round 2, will have more details, more fine parts, which means more fun in the box. We've got things together ready to paint all in the same colors. We're going to prime. We've got our door panels, our back seat, and I glued the front sport bucket seats together. So that's ready to go. You know how I always like to separate the trees so I can work on things together. We got our radiator hose, we got our drive shaft and our wheel backs all on this little tree. We can get those primed. We got our dashboard cut mostly off its tree and that's ready to go. I've got the belt pulley system all glued together. That's ready to paint up. Then we'll attach our chrome alternator to that part right there and we'll be all set. These headers are gorgeous. And you could buy these to use with any other kit. They go together lovely. I love the bolting plate there. They're two parts like we saw in the parts review and they go together seamlessly. They are really stunning actually. They're gonna look beautiful on the car when we're all done and I can paint those separately. I really like that. The radiator support and the radiator itself and the battery will get painted the same black that GM had them. Now you could attach this to the chassis, but I wanna be able to get the engine in later, paint it all separate. So I have it on its own tree. It's gonna get painted up, then I can super glue it into place. The interior pan, we will just get that painted. I did absolutely nothing to it. It needs all of its interior pieces put together. I did leave the header dumps on their trees. We'll get those painted up. I'm also going to try and experiment with the exhaust. And I want to see if I can just run the exhaust and then the dumps off the exhaust off the side. I'm not going to run the entire exhaust. If I can't, I'll just run the dumps off the headers. But I want to see if I can make somewhat of a street legal exhaust system with the factory parts, but not have the second mufflers and the tailpipes out all the way out the back. You kind of know what I'm talking about with a set of Flowmasters. The steering wheel on mine needs to be painted my interior color. I will re-silver up the center bars when I do that, but I will be priming and covering up all that chrome. The engine and engine stand. Isn't that a beautiful little setup? That just pulls off there. We've got our engine in progress. We can see our rockers. We can see down into the valley there. We can see our caps and everything on the bottom. That is pretty awesome. So we're going to get that painted and hand painted and detailed. Our engine stand is a lovely part. Fits that engine. Will fit other engines, obviously. Our three-wheeled engine stand with our supports. And it actually looks like it's bolted onto the back of the motor. I just got to make sure I have the right side. Push it around. It actually looks like it's bolted onto the back of the motor. Isn't that nice? Isn't that creative? I love little add-ons like that. We've got the engine in here. I did not go factory. I went with the larger carburetor, and I'm going to be painting the intake, but I want to get it all painted as one. Then I'll do all my hand painting. You know, I like doing that all the time, and a lot of people like to do it separately. Cool. You build your cars your way. I build mine my way, and I like doing that little bit of extra hand painting. It just gets me excited. Got our chrome parts here. I'm going to be doing something to all of these chrome parts on one tree. We got our rear wheel trim. We got our underbody trim. We got our bumper. We got our grill. Our headlights surround. We got our hood. We got our taillights. We got our center console all on there. So I want to decorate that in the same manner. And we've got our body and chassis. The hood slides off because there's nothing to support it right now. But you'll see how that'll fit on. I did cut out the hood. Put the hood scoop on. I like that look. It's going to go great with my idea for this car. That fits on there very well. The chassis fits inside the body just fine. It just snaps down in. You just spread the back of the body a little bit and the rest just drops in. The inner fenders line up immediately. Check out that fit around there. That's not glued together. I'm not holding it in place. That's a nice fit inside there. Real well done. Got our shock tower, our mounts and everything. Got all of our detail. Got our steering box glued in. I mean, it's really well detailed. Let me pull it out, give you a closer look. There we go. Body doesn't need any prep work except for removing those casting lugs. Check out that front suspension. Kingpins. It does have pullsable steering if you choose not to glue those. Got our springs, suspension arms, the A-arms on there. Got our rear suspension. I even put the optional traction bars on. I can hand paint those a separate color once it's all been painted up. Got our shocks in, leaf spring package, differential, cross member, all that is installed. And you could build it all up in one or do it in sections, however you choose. I like to build things all up in one and hand paint anything I want. So I'm gonna hit the painting section. We'll see you over there. all that work brings us to right here, and I'm really liking all of this. We've got the interior put together. We've got the engine and the engine bay and all glued up. We've got this, one of the coolest diorama pieces I've ever seen included in a model. I've got the block disassembled. We did that dry brushing with the silver to show where the gaskets would have been for the most parts, so it would be all bare metal. And then we've got it ready to go. And then I just did some black wash in the valves, or on the rockers and inside the valley and all that, just to show that it's dirty inside there. We did that very light coat of orange over the black. That looks superb, and I love how that looks like an engine in the process. That's the one he pulled out. The one he's got under the hood is much nicer. Check out that wheel and tire package. A lot of you are going to want to transverse that, do a black wall. Totally cool. I really like the classy look of the white walls with the custom wheels. The thin white walls, I think those look tough. We got the tires sanded down. They look realistic. Those are ready to be pushed onto the chassis. Check out that grill. Ready to go on. Headlights glued in. You see when the Mod Podge dries, you can't even tell it's there. We got the yellow lights. We got the blackouts on the grill, just like the box art. We got the trim ready to go with its washes in it. That's all set up. I lost a little piece of trim, part 110, no idea where it is. That's for the front fender trim. So I will just color that in with some silver, or we can pretend that it fell off. The way I'm building this car is it's the third or fourth owner. They're already modifying it. It's nowhere near 1966, more like 86. So they're customizing it, doing their own thing. Here we've got that two-tone red interior. I really like how that came out. The darker red for the package shelf and the carpets, the lighter red for the vinyl door panels and the seats, and that awesome dashboard with the black and the silver. That's cool looking with that red steering wheel. I copied pictures of this nice SS online that had a red interior. And then, since it wasn't exactly like this interior, I just matched it as close as I can. But take a look at that. Nice accents there for the dash and everything. It's a good looking ride. The chassis here is ready to go. Under the hood looks awesome. Got our reservoir tank, got our battery in now. Didn't even paint the reservoir tank. That white plastic looks excellent the way it is. Just put the black cap on it. Got the engine installed with one carburetor, one velocity stack. We could have done both, you know, it depends on what you want to do. And those nice custom valve covers on there. Underneath, check it out. Definitely a car that's been driven for a while, but is completely serviceable and usable. What I did was I cut that stock exhaust way down, took it off the headers, joined it in, cut it down, and now we'll have our dumps that I've custom cut as well. I'm going to end up gluing those in like so, so that we have a street exhaust on this car. All right, it's got a muffler on it. It's legal. Painted the track bars. Everybody wants you to see those when they put them on. So I did that, and those look excellent, and underneath looks superb with the white Ceram-coated headers. So it's not the exact fastest car on the street, but this thing's going to surprise a lot of people out there. It is built up a little bit, and we have no idea what the internals are on that motor either. He could have put a lot of money on some forged internals for that thing. So it's going to be a sweet ride. We're ready to go. I just have to get the air cleaner attached. When we're all done, we got the car all together. What I did, I didn't do this on camera. Before I brought it over to the table and did any trim work or anything, I did shoot it with some semi-gloss clear. I wanted to knock down the shine way down on the body. I like the black. I am going to apply one coat of Future after I get the decals on, the Super Sport decals and the emblems on it and everything. I will do one coat of Future, but it was a super gloss, and within 20 years, even if you waxed it all the time, the paint was going to fade because it has to sit outside, and that's what I wanted it to do. So now we have a more of a dead paint appearance and a faded appearance. I did heavier on the top, real light mist on the sides. The sides are still much shinier. That's what I want it to look like paint starting to go bad, got wear and tear on it. We're using it. He's already pulled the factory motor out of it. That's the look I love going for. He's already put that hood scoop on, so he primered the hood after he cut it, bolted the trim back on, and we're all set. So that's going to look tough on there with his motor underneath it. I'm going to push everything together. I've just got to use some super glue, glue stuff on. I always use dollar store super glue. We'll get those parts on, get those tiny decals on, get one brushed on coat of Future like I like to do, and we'll be back for that final. My version of the 66 Chevy Nova SS and 125th scale from AMT is all done. Another kit that's super easy to build. If I run into problems with these kits, I always tell you guys, if the body was kind of hard to fit on, this one actually just drops down. You just pry it open and it snaps right on. So that part of the review is super easy. And always remember, we're not reviewing how I chose to paint or detail the kit. My reviews are about how the kits go together, and then the rest of it is just all decided by me and based on my skills, which aren't show quality skills, they're just model skills. So I love building kits, and that's why I like building them my way. I love the separate taillights, the trim on the bottom of the doors, the back of the fenders, the trunk lid, the taillights, the bumper. It all fits on real nice and is attached with some cheap dollar store glue. My favorite little accessory has got to be that engine stand. Whoop. Engine stand and partially torn apart V8. I just think that looks so cool. The details on the car are very, very sweet. This one, the hood comes off so easily. We can just pry it off and set it next to the car. While it spins, it's got that primer hood because he just put the hood scoop on it. He cut open the stock hood, put the hood scoop on it, threw some paint on it to keep the welds and stuff from rusting, threw the original hood ornament back on it, the emblem on the hood, bolted that back on so we didn't have two little holes in the front of the hood, and he's out cruising with his built 327 under the hood. So it's a sweet looking ride with that red interior, the darker red carpeting and the package shelf. I like that combination. I like all my little weathering on it underneath. Detailing it, making it look cool with those track bars, my custom exhaust operation on there, which went off without a hitch. I didn't know if I'd be able to do that, but everything lined up, so you can feel free if you want to put mufflers on it and use those headers to hack it up like I did, or even extend them farther back and run tailpipes, whatever you want. Plenty of cars run headers and full exhaust systems to be street legal. They put quieter exhaust on it. The underhood detail is very good. We got the full radiator. We got the reservoir tank. We got the battery. We got our master cylinder. We got a wiper motor on there. We got a blower motor in there. And that nice V8 that you can run completely stock with a stock air cleaner or modify it. You can do whatever you want to this thing. You've got, when you're done, remember, complete set of custom wheels, air cleaner, valve covers, everything on there. So it looks great, and I really enjoyed building it. I hope you like coming along. It's definitely a must buy. I've got the links below to where you can pick this up, because this 66 Nova has been in stock for a few weeks now, so anyone can grab it. You don't have to wait for it. It's not on pre-order. I will link to those in the description. Thanks for watching the workshop. As always, I end every video, build your models for you. You're the ones that are working on them. No one else out in internet land, so don't build to make them happy. Build to make you happy, and the way you decide to do everything is the right way because it is yours. Thanks for watching the workshop. Have fun, and I'll see you all at the next review.